What's good, everybody? This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters, the biggest Miami Hurricane fan of all time. Today, we are going to be talking about how to add and subtract integers. And we're going to talk about this from two different concepts. All right? So let's start off with the first concept. So the first concept says that if we have the same sign, meaning both numbers are positive or both numbers are negative, this is how we're going to solve it. We're going to add those numbers together. And then after we add them together, we're going to keep its sign. Okay? And this is what I mean by that. If we're adding two positive numbers, it's just going to be a larger positive number. And the same thing can be said about negative numbers. So let's start off with an example. We have 17 plus 9. We know once we add these two numbers together, we're going to get 26. However, what if we were talking about adding negative 17 plus negative 9? And what I want you guys to know and understand is that we're going to attack it the same way we did the positive side. Only difference now is that our answer is going to be negative. So negative 17 plus negative 9, add those two numbers together, we get 26, and we know that it should be negative. All right? And what I want to do before we go into the second example is show you another way that this can be written. So you could have something like this, negative 17 minus 9. So this right here is the same exact thing as the previous example I just did. And once we solve, we're going to get the same negative 26. All right? So just try not to get fooled or confused with that, because that's the trick that they try to throw in. So let's go over to one more example, and then we're going to move on to one of our different signs. So let's say we had the problem. Well, let's switch back to black so it could stick out some. Negative 16 minus 8. So just like the previous example, I'm going to rewrite this problem another way. And what I want you guys to understand is that both of these are the same exact problem, and we'll have the same exact answer, okay? Which will be 24, negative 24. All right, so whether the signs are both positive or both negative, all you're going to do is add those two numbers together, then keep the sign, whether it's positive or negative. Now, let's go on to our second concept. And I think the second concept is the one that's a little bit more challenging at times. So this second concept is when we're adding and subtracting integers that have different signs. So that just means that one number is positive and the other number is negative. So once this happens, this is how we're going to solve these problems. We're going to drop the sign. And when we drop the sign, we want to make both numbers positive. It's easier to work with. After we drop those signs, we're then going to turn it into a subtraction problem, right? So we're going to subtract. After we subtract now and get our answer, the final step is to go back to the original problem and keep the sign of the larger number. Okay, and this is what I mean. So let's go into some examples. So I have the example negative 5 plus 4. So based on what the rule says, they want us to rewrite this problem as a subtraction problem. So I'm going to have 5 minus 4, and I know that answer is going to be 1, right? But when I go back to my original problem, I noticed that 5 is the larger number and my larger number is negative, right? So negative 5 plus 4 is going to be negative 1. Okay? Let's go into our second example, and I'm going to use one from above. So we have 17 plus negative 9. That's our original problem. So once we rewrite this as a subtraction problem, 17 minus 9, we know that we're going to get 8 as an answer, right? But now, when we look back at the original problem, the bigger number was positive, so we know that our answer is also going to be positive, okay? And then wrap this on up. Let's do one last example. We have negative 25 plus 17, right? We're going to drop these signs, so we're going to have 25 and 17. Once we turn this into a subtraction problem, we know that when we take 17 from 25, that gives us 8. But now we're going back to the original problem, right? We're back in red. And when I look at this, even though 25 is the larger number is negative. So 8 is also going to be negative. So guys, remember, when you're adding and subtracting integers, there's two different scenarios that you're going to see. You're going to see a scenario where both numbers have the same sign. When they have the same sign, add them, keep the same sign. When they have different signs, right? One is positive, one is negative. Let's drop the signs and make both numbers positive. Turn the problem into a subtraction problem. And then when we get our answer, we're going to go and take the sign of the larger number. So guys, next time you're adding and subtracting integers, hope this video was helpful for you. Please make sure that you guys like, leave a comment, subscribe to our channel, and join us next time. This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters, biggest Miami Hurricane fan of all time. We'll see you next time.